Greetings and welcome to the Introduction to Astronomy. One of the things that I like to do in each of my introductory astronomy classes is to begin the class with the astronomy picture of the day from the NASA website, that is apod.nasa.gov/apod. And today's picture for December the 9th of 2019, well, it is titled Looking Sideways from the Parker Solar Probe. So what do we see here? Well, this is a video clip, actually a compressed video clip, looking at 14 seconds worth of data that was taken over 9 days. So we'll see some of the areas around the sun. And in fact, you can see the solar corona off to the left hand side there. This is the outer atmosphere of the sun, and you'll be able to see how it varies with activity going on down on the sun. Now, further out, we'll be able to see a number of stars. And as we play the video, you'll be able to watch as it's compressed kind of a high speed as to what is going on here over the course of this week and a half. And one of the things you'll be able to notice is the Milky Way. You'll be able to see the Milky Way galaxy there as it passes through this area as the probe moves in its orbit around the sun. Now, one of the interesting things, the Parker Solar Probe is designed in an elliptical orbit designed to take it in very close to the sun and to be able to give us our detailed studies of the sun and to be able to try to learn more about it. Now, traveling to the sun is harder than you might think. It is not easy to just go travel into the sun. It's not as though you can just launch something from Earth and let it go and it will fall into the sun, because that thing object launched from Earth will have the same orbital energy as the Earth and will be whipping around the sun once a year. So in order to get it in closer to the sun, we have to lose that orbital energy that the Earth gave it upon launch. So it is actually harder to send things in closer to the sun than it is to send them much further out. But it does give us a chance to study the sun in much more detail. And if you think about that, this is one of the reasons that Mercury has been less well explored than other planets. We've sent more probes to Saturn than we have to Mercury, even though Mercury is many times closer. It is much harder and takes more gravity assists, using the gravity of other planets, to be able to get objects close in towards the sun to places such as Mercury. It is also difficult because of the intense energy and heat of the sun that could come very close to frying equipment. So a solar shield is needed to protect the equipment from the sun itself, as temperatures will rise rather high and reaching 1,000 degrees or more as it gets very close to the sun. So they need to be shielded from this and from the intensity and brightness. We all know how intense the sun is here on Earth. Well, this is going to be many times closer to the sun, and therefore the sun will appear many times brighter than it does from here on Earth. So it could very easily overwhelm any equipment that we see. In addition, towards the very end of the video, you can actually see a planet there. Now, there are several others that could be planets as well, but this one is very clearly a planet, as you can notice that it moves its position relative to the stars. So the stars keep their same positions relative to each other. And one of the ways planets were discovered was that they moved their position, that they wandered around the stars and did not keep the same position over time. So the Parker Solar Probe is continuing its mission and will, over the next few years, make observations as its orbit loops it in closer and closer to the sun, giving us a close-up look at the object that really gives us nearly all of our energy here on Earth. So that was our picture of the day for December the 9th of 2019. It was titled Looking Sideways from the Parker Solar Probe. We'll be back again tomorrow for the next picture, previewed to be Satellite Swarm. So we'll see what that is about tomorrow. And until then, have a great day, everyone, and I will see you in class.